ask anyone going into hospital about their main concerns, and near the top of the list will be safe and clean equipment. These are the backroom technicians who make sure that every instrument used at the McIndoe Hospital is totally sterilised using some of the world's best equipment. Its reputation is so high that its sterile services department is trusted by many other hospitals to clean all their surgical instruments.
Sterilisation and cleanliness is of course very important in any hospital. The instrumentations are going into sterile cavities of the body, and we sterilise to prevent infections. Due to all the stories of MRSA and its such infections, we are vitally important within McIndoe. We base ourselves on the highest standards possible. This room, for example, is so clean that we could actually pack drugs as a pharmacist in this room. Most hospitals have a lower level, which is acceptable for packing instruments, but we are actually monitored higher than theatres. So this department is very clean, and so is the whole hospital. The instrumentation comes in via the what we call the washroom. It's brought from theatres to us. It is broken down, all the instrumentation that opened up so everything can be washed properly, all the nooks and crannies. Once it's passed a wash phase, it goes into a decontamination phase. This is done by reverse osmosis water, which is the purest water you can get. And this is heated up to 90 degrees Celsius to kill most organisms that you can inquire in, soft soil, wet soil instrumentation. After that process, it is then packed by a technician. They check all the joints to make sure that instrumentation cannot break during surgery, that they're functional, so scissors are maintained sharp. Once they've gone through that process and everything is in that tray, it's then wrapped up into specially designed paper, which allows steam penetration in and air out, but it doesn't let microorganisms in.
As the disinfected kit moves on to the final stage of sterilisation, white tape is wrapped around the parcels. It needs to turn dark to show it's properly sterile after the final process.
And then it is placed through the hatch into a steriliser. The steriliser then pulls a vacuum to remove the air out of the chamber. It then pulses steam in, detects whether there's air in the chamber. Once the steam's in and we reach a certain pressure, it switches over to sterilise. It's scientifically proven that that will kill most microorganisms. And after that process, everything will be ready to be used in the theatre once more. We have some of the top consultants in the country. We have the state-of-the-art facility to back the consultants up. They have extremely high standards, and we have to provide them with high standard equipment so they can maintain their high standards of surgery.